November 5th, 1987, the Grateful Dead made a video for Throwing Stones, an MTV video. They'd already made their Touch of Grey video earlier that year in May of 87. And this time they were shooting this video at an abandoned high school in Oakland, California. I lived in Oakland, California at the time, and I just happened to live across the street from an abandoned high school. So on the day that the rumors came true that they were going to be filming this video, I just walked over there with a couple of cameras and pockets full of film, and I literally stayed on set that entire day for 10 hours doing stills of the Grateful Dead making the Throwing Stones video. I had no special permission to be there. After 3, 4, 5 hours, somebody said to me, "Who are you?" And I said, "I'm Jay Blakesberg from Relics Magazine." And they said, "Okay." And so I was there just all day shooting pictures of the Grateful Dead making the Throwing Stones video. Obviously, we know the words to that song, and so they built this giant set. They had these weird oil coats, Australian oil coats as costumes. They all were wearing these weird hats. And it was fascinating to watch this whole thing happen. But while I was there, I got this shot, which is the one of Garcia holding up the Happy New Year sign, the most bootleg photograph ever of Jerry Garcia. You've seen it a million times on t-shirts and posters and memes online where it says, "Happy birthday, happy Christmas, happy Hanukkah, happy Easter, happy Passover, happy anniversary," whatever people want to say, it's that photo has said it. And I was actually the first one to bootleg that photo. I actually took the picture pre-computer, took a piece of white paper, cut it out with an X-Acto razor blade on the little sign, and I wrote, "I need a miracle ticket," and then re-photographed it with a new negative and made prints of that. And I was the first guy to bootleg that photo, but it's been everywhere. But I just love these photos because they're just so unique with the band in these kind of weird costumes in this weird setting that's, you know, kind of ominous. So cool stuff, had a great hang with these guys, and Kreutzmann wasn't there that day. For some reason, he was unable to attend that video shoot. They did some live video of them in the studio playing instruments that get edited in, and that's where you see Kreutzmann. But Robbie Taylor, one of the longtime Grateful Dead road crew guys, stood in for Robbie, wore the long jacket, put a mask over his face, and pretended to be Bill Kreutzmann during that day.